Alex is a skilled network administrator responsible for overseeing the infrastructure of a large enterprise organization. With security concerns at the forefront, the organization is considering a shift from the traditional VPN setup to a more advanced Zero Trust Network Access solution, or ZTNA. In this pursuit, Alex has chosen to showcase the capabilities of Skyhigh Security Service Edge's platform to his management. Notably, Skyhigh Security's SSE platform leverages a familiar web policy engine and technology that already underpins their organizations and its operations. This consistency ensures that data awareness and browser isolation features remain at the organization's disposal to secure private assets effectively. Through this quick demonstration, Alex intends to provide insight into both the fundamental configuration and the platform's advanced functionalities, shedding light on the tangible benefits of adopting this modernized approach to network security. So let's take a look and see what Alex has for his demo. Before we begin, let's first introduce the Secure App Connector. The Secure App Connector plays a fundamental role in implementing the ZTNA architecture as it facilitates the secure communication between the user or device requesting access and the resources they are trying to get to. For resources hosted within the organization's data centers or private cloud, the Secure App Connector must be deployed on-premises or in the private cloud infrastructure. Multiple connectors can be deployed for redundancy and/or geographical requirements. The connector itself is software that can be deployed virtually. The connector acts as a gateway for incoming access requests from external users and devices. They validate the user's identity, enforce access controls, and provide a secure tunnel to the internal resource. The connector helps to protect the resource from direct exposure to the public internet while providing a secure access mechanism for authorized users. Once a connector is deployed, its status, communication, and utilization details can be monitored from the console. Here you can see Alex logging into the Skyhigh Security console and showing us the status of the Secure App Connector. Once the connector has been successfully deployed, it's time to publish and configure any applications that require access. From our connector here, Alex can see which applications are assigned to it. When users request access to an application, that request reaches the connector through a Skyhigh Security point of presence. The connector then forwards that request to the actual application service. And when it comes to creating access to a private application, all that is needed is the protocol, defining the host name to access. It doesn't have to be publicly resolvable. The application port number, and then finally mapping that to the connector itself. With a connector in place and our private applications configured, let's next take a look and see how policies can be created to control access. A private access policy includes rules that specify criteria based on the application, application group, username, user group, process name, device profile, and location. Actions for configuring access to private applications include allow and block actions, which will simply grant or block access to the application accordingly. Allow with DLP will grant access to the application while also enforcing any predefined DLP classifications to protect sensitive data. Allow with web policy will grant access to web application while also applying full web policy controls similar to Skyhigh Security's cloud proxy. And then using the isolate action, the private web application will be accessed through a remote browser isolation session. To demonstrate the access and policies in action, let's switch over to a client machine that's deployed with the Skyhigh Security client proxy. Alex opens a browser and requests access to one of the private applications, but is first redirected and prompted to authenticate against their SAML compliant identity provider, which happens to be Okta in this case. Users can also authenticate to private applications seamlessly using Skyhigh client proxy as well. After authenticating, Alex is taken to the Private Access Dashboard, which lists all the available applications that have been published to the connector. Here we can see all the available web applications that are enabled for access. Alex first clicks an application and is blocked to demonstrate the user's experience if they were to access an application that wasn't allowed or if they violated policy. Next, he accesses an internal wiki application, which has a policy to detect and block sensitive information. To demonstrate DLP, Alex tries to post PII data to the wiki and is blocked from doing so. Even though we're only showing a block on the upload here, the same can be done for downloads as well. For the next application, Alex demonstrates private application access using remote browser isolation technology. This can be useful in situations where the user or device posture is out of compliance, but access can still be granted with added activity controls to prevent actions like copy-pasting, uploading, and downloading. Skyhigh uses pixel mapping techniques to capture the pixel-level representation of a website content and then transmitting only the visual information back to the user's device. Here we can see Alex logging in to view invoices from the CRM application. You can see that the user is able to interact with the application, but as soon as they try to upload any type of attachments to the invoice, or if they try to do a download, you'll see that those controls and those blocks are enforced as well. Skyhigh Security Private Access supports both client and clientless methods when it comes to enabling access using remote browser isolation technology. This also includes data loss prevention. And finally, we're going to see Alex loading the private application dashboard again to show that other ports and protocols can be leveraged as well. In this example, we can see that SSH is published, and we also have a policy to allow access to an internal Linux server. Alex configures his SSH client to point to the private hostname of the internal Linux server, and as you can see, is able to successfully connect to the server using SSH over private access. Skyhigh Security differentiates itself from the rest with the platform's robust web policy engine, remote browser isolation technology, and comprehensive data awareness. These are all important components to consider when making the strategic shift towards an advanced ZTNA architecture for any organization's commitment to modernizing network security for enhanced protection and efficiency. Thanks for taking the time to watch this demo.